Hey there. Hope you're having a good week starting out today. Thanks for taking a minute to look at this little video. Anthony Reece here at VO101. Listen, I was networking a little bit today with some veterans in business and fellow colleagues, both in my database and on LinkedIn. And I got a couple of emails, interesting enough, from a few people that have been in business a long time, telling me that they've been in the business 30 years, 25 years, one said. One even said 35 to 40 years, and so they don't really need training. Well, I got to be honest and tell you, you know the old saying, you can't teach an old dog new tricks? That's not true. There is lots of things that old dogs like myself and veterans in the business need to stay fresh and, if you will, recertify their voiceover skills. It is a much more millennial-based digital social media marketplace today. It is a global market on top of that, with literally people in the voiceover business scuba diving in the Cayman Islands, off the coast of Jamaica, in Australia, overseas in the military, basically worldwide, from India to Italy to South America to the States to Canada, you name it. There is a competition like nowhere in the past has ever seen. Therefore, if you are a veteran like myself, and you've been around the business a long time, then there is nothing more important this day and age for you to stay sharp and make sure that you don't still market yourself and promote yourself as a 70s, 80s, give or take 90s talent. Today is a much different marketplace. You're competing with trained voice talent who are much more cutting edge, much more street savvy, much more sophisticated, and the bottom line is much more trained professionally. There was a time back in the day when we were all in the business starting out where it was the whole, like I've talked about before, Home Depot mentality, do it yourself and save. A lot of old veterans who have been around the business from the 80s to 90s to big fish in a little pond era have kind of lost touch with what's going on in the market today. And I'm one of those old veterans from back in the hairband days of the 80s, starting out in radio in the 80s and working my way through 80s, 90s, early 2000s to today, being involved in the marketplace after basically 35 years since I was a high school student. I can tell you right now, half of my voice talent who work with me from a student perspective are veterans with 20 plus years experience. The reason they come to me is they are starving. They come to me to basically refresh and reinvent themselves as artists for the year 2022, the 21st century. Bottom line is you can teach old dogs new tricks. The reality is you got to be able to be a much sharper, much more social savvy, and a much more flexible, diverse talent. Those days of being the big fish in a little pond are gone. There's a small percentage of us out there in the business who can still make a pretty good living off a handful of clients that we have on a regular basis. But the reality is, in order to audition and compete in the pay-to-play, click-to-cast, virtual, web-based marketplace, you're competing with hundreds, if not thousands, of young demographic voice talent, ranging from 21 to 25 to 30, 35 to 40 to 45. Demographics are no big deal anymore. Pretty much everybody in the business can be 35, can be 45, can be 25, because most voice talent these days are trained to be diverse. If they're not trained to be diverse, they're not making a good living. The reality is, like I tell all of my students, you have to be a country buffet. You have to be able to deliver whatever the client is looking for. You can't be a one-dimensional voice talent in today's day and age. You got to work at lower registers, upper registers, middle registers. You got to be able to offer the client like a buffet, golden corral, whatever they're looking for. You can no longer be a big fish in a little pond because that little pond is now a global pond. So, short and sweet and to the point, if you're like someone that I've talked with earlier, and you think that because you've been in business 30, 35, 40 years, if you're semi-retired and you're not as aggressive and you're making a good living, more power to you. God bless you. But the reality is, if you're not seeing revenue coming in and you're not basically competing on a level that is of any significance, the reality is you might want to look in the mirror, as old Michael Jackson, rest in peace, says, and take a look at the man in the mirror or the woman in the mirror and consider, have you stayed up on your skill set? Are you able to say that you have recertified your voiceover skills over the years? Have you formally trained and then stayed on top of training? Have you attended webinars? Are you continuing what they call continued learning, continued education? I'm a believer in the old slogan, never stop learning. I'm a big believer in when we think we've known everything and we know everything, guess what? We basically come in last. The reality is that individual talent who is up on the current marketplace, who is sharp, who has no rust, who yearns for, has a passion for the art, and never wants to stop yearning, they're the true leaders in the industry today. The rest of those who think they know everything, don't need training, and have been in business 25, 30, 35 years, the reality of the matter is they got to take a look at themselves and consider, am I still aggressive? Do I still want to compete? Do I really need to maybe refresh myself? Most of the talent that I work with who have been around the business for a long time come to me to reinvent themselves. They come to me to rebrand, repackage, and refresh their skill set so they can compete on a much more 21st century level. Back in the day, we could basically talk in front of the microphone, deliver a read, and our money voice is what sold. The reality is that is in the market today. Anybody who tells you otherwise is, well, you know what? The reality is there is a very small percentage of veterans in the business that have a network, good old boys, good old girl club. They have an agent they've been with. They have a client base that is strong they've been with forever. But 95 to 98% of the rest of the marketplace is made up of one-off jobs that you get a gig and you get another gig and you get another gig, and the ability to keep those and retain those clients is a thing of the past and is not the norm in this era we live in today. So from one veteran in the business to another, reality is never stop learning. Go back out there, compete, but be able to go out there fresh, compete on a 21st century level, and don't consider yourself a veteran of the business and get lost in the old school way of thinking. Stay sharp, stay fresh, and never stop learning.